Next topic is learning with perfect domain theories, that is Prolog, EBG. Prolog, it is nothing but programming by logic. EBG, it is our explanation based learning. We know that analytical learning, it is nothing but an explanation based learning, correct? So analytical learning, we say that it is mainly based on the explanation. The explanation based learning, in the sense, we know that an instance-based learning or our decision tree or our artificial neural network, it is purely based on the training example. The machine, it is going to refer to the database, where in the database there will be an each and every training examples along with the different attributes and the attribute values. So by the machine is going to learn from the training example. And whereas in an analytical based learning, the machine is going to learn based upon the explanation of the training example. So the explanation, in the sense, the theories, the theory will be returned or given for each of the training example. That is known as explanation based learning. So we say that analytical learning, it is based on explanation, which is in turn related to various domain theory. A domain theory, it is nothing but the knowledge on the specific field. Suppose if I consider an example of an field, that is a physics stream. So it forms a domain theory. If I consider the programming language, it forms another domain. So we say that each and every domain, it is the knowledge about the specific field. So analytical learning, it is purely based upon an explanation. Explanation in the sense, the theories or the words that is written for each of the training examples in the database. So the machine is going to consider here the explanation rather than a training example. So analytical learning, it is based on a domain theory. Domain theory, it is nothing but the knowledge on the specific field. We say that a domain theory is said to be correct. So we say that a domain theory is said to be correct and complete. Now, how we say that, what is meant by correctness of a domain theory and what is meant by the completeness of a domain theory? So we say that the domain theory is correct and complete. A domain theory is said to be correct if each and every assertions made by it is truthful about the world. So each and every assertion, in the sense, each and every declaration that is made by the training database, we say that each and every assertion that is made or the declaration that is made, it is true about the world. So understand, suppose if I consider a domain theory, domain as a physics, and in a physics, if I say the declaration that there is a gravitational force everywhere, the statement is correct and it is applied to each and everything. So that's why whatever the assertions or the declarations that is made in a particular domain, it must be correct and it must be applied to everything. Next, we say that a domain theory is complete with respect to the given target concept and instance space if the domain theory covers each and every positive examples. So what is meant by positive example? If the target concept is yes in an enjoy sport, so that is said to be as a positive example. If I say that the target concept of an enjoy sport is false, then it is said to be a negative example. So we say that a domain theory is complete when it covers each and every positive examples, that is a target concept is yes, and by default the negative examples. So notice that in our definition of a completeness, it doesn't require the domain theory be able to prove that negative examples do not satisfy the target concept. However, since we are using a Prolog convention, Prolog in the sense that is programming by logic, the unprovable assertions, unprovable declarations, in the sense, it is assumed to be as a false. So understand, the provable declaration, so which I say that it is true everywhere, it is considered as a provable and it is said to be a positive example, and the completeness, it includes the positive examples totally, and which are unprovable assertions or unprovable declarations. Suppose I say that there is no gravitational force in the space, there is a zero gravity, then it is an unprovable declaration. So in that sense, means it is not true everywhere. So that is considered to be as a default false example or the default negative example, and the domain theory by default covers both the positive and the negative examples. So understand, analytical learning, it is nothing but an explanation based learning. Now explanation based learning, it is based upon the domain theory. What is meant by a domain theory? Domain theory, it is nothing but the knowledge about the specific field. We say that a domain theory is said to be correct and complete when we say that it is correct. So because all the assertions or the declaration that is made is true about the world, then we say that a domain theory is correct. We say that a domain theory is complete when it covers all the positive examples and default as a negative examples also. Now let us see what is a need of a domain theory. So this is the two needs of a domain theory. First need is in order to automatically improve the performance. So this is the first domain theory need. This is the first domain theory need. First is to improve the performance. So in order to improve the performance, so that is automatically the performance must be improved. Correct? If a domain theory is considered which have only the knowledge about the particular stream, that is not sufficient. For example, if I consider the board status. So suppose if I consider an example of playing the chess. So and in that, in playing the chess, if I consider the board states in which I am about to lose my queen. So that is the status of the board. So board states in which I am about to lose my queen. So that is the status about the board. Now only having a knowledge about the stream is not important. So at that time, what the opponent must do when this condition occurs? When the explanation of all this is given automatically and the performance of all this is improved automatically as per the need, then at that time we need a domain theory. Understand? In order to improve the performance automatically. So every time considering the training examples, in training examples some of the attribute values will be missing, but whereas in an explanation, by seeing at the explanation overall theory about the domain, we can automatically improve the performance of playing the chess. Next, the second need here is, it is very difficult to have a perfect or a correct and a complete domain theory. So it is necessary to assume and start from an imperfect theory and try to make it perfect. So always we are going to start it from an imperfect theory, and then by improving the performance, we'll arrive at a perfect domain theory. So that's why we need a domain theory. So what are the two needs in a domain theory? Main two needs in a domain theory. The first need here is, in order to improve the performance, we are using a domain theory. Next is step by step improvement of the domain theory. That is, we are going to start it from an imperfect theory itself. It is very difficult to achieve the correct and a complete domain theory. So we are going to start it from an imperfect theory and then try to make it perfect. Next subtopic is illustrative example. So in an illustrative example, so here we are going to consider a prologue EBG. It is nothing but a programming by logic. EBG, it is nothing but an explanation based learning as a domain theory. So here in this the algorithm, it is mainly based on sequential covering and Hondt losses. Now what is meant by sequential learning? We have already known sequential learning or sequential covering, it is nothing but it is a kind of an algorithm. It is a learning algorithm where the machine is going to learn only one particular line or one particular training example or one particular line. It is going to save it in the memory, and then when it jumps to the second training example or second line, at that time, the first training example will be removed from its memory. So this is the sequential covering algorithm. We have already seen the sequential covering algorithm in a learning based system. Next is Horn classes. About the Horn classes also, we have also studied. Horn classes, it is nothing but, it is a conjunction of literals based on some predicates, and at most one positive or at most one positive literal we should have in our complete database. At most one positive literal or sample must be present. So that is an Horn clauses. So we are using a Prolog EBJ algorithm by using a domain theory of safe to stack. So this is an example in order to illustrate about the domain theory. So what is this safe to stack example? I'll explain and explain about this domain theory. So here in an illustrative example, we are using an Prolog EBJ algorithm. Prolog EBJ, it is nothing but a programming by logic. EBJ, it is nothing but an explanation based learning. So this algorithm, it is based on sequential covering and Horn classes. So this algorithm, it is illustrated in three steps, or it is performed in three steps. First one is explaining the new positive training example. Second one is analyzing this explanation to determine an appropriate generalization. Third one is refining the current hypothesis by adding a new Horn clause rule to cover the positive examples as well as other similar instances. So as a whole, this Prolog EBJ, it is based on sequential covering and Horn classes, and it has been performed in three steps, that is explaining, analyzing and refining. So explaining a positive training example, analyzing the explanation in order to determine an appropriate generalization, and refining the current hypothesis by adding a Horn clauses to cover the positive examples. So these are the three steps, and we are applying it to an example, that is safe to stack. In a safe to stack, we have a domain theory. So what is this example safe to stack? I'll explain in the next video. So these three steps are very important, and it is a confirmed question.